Hey everyone, welcome back to another video. So in today's video, couple little things we're gonna do. I'm gonna kind of give you a little bit of a channel update as to what's kind of going on, especially with the whole coronavirus and everything kind of going on. It is affecting me directly, so I'll give you a little bit of an update about that. Three new jerseys to show you that I'm really excited about. And I'll kind of give you guys a little bit of a set tour that I have. Like I said, the whole coronavirus has kind of affected me. It's given me a little bit of time on my hands. So I kind of have rearranged the basement a little bit. So I'll kind of give you a little bit of a walkthrough and show you what I have down here. So stay tuned, we'll get right into that. Alright, so first, a little bit of an update. I am no longer working. I'm not sick, I don't have the virus, at least not that I know of yet, so that's always good. But my work is closed down for a minimum of 2 weeks, minimum being the key word there, so we're not actually sure what's going to actually happen with that, how long we're going to be. 2 weeks would be ideal. I could use a nice 2 week break, that'd be fantastic. About a month after that, once a month hits of not working, then I'll kind of start panicking. I got a nice chunk kind of set aside. I didn't really want to use it for this. I had other plans. Doesn't look like that's going to be happening at all. Supposed to be taking a trip. And I said I was going to stop buying jerseys, and that was a bit of a lie. Well, not really. I didn't intend to start buying jerseys again this quickly, but with me not going on the trip, I probably should have only gotten one, maybe two tops, probably not a third. Especially one of them I did end up paying full price for. I'm not particularly proud of it, but oh well. So yeah, hopefully I can give you guys some more videos over these next couple weeks, next month or here or so. And I would like to show you guys my entire jersey collection. I have, I think, 6 jerseys out right now getting crested, so I'm not going to do it until I have all my jerseys in my possession. I am done buying jerseys for a little while because I simply can't afford it right now. I didn't think our work was actually going to be getting closed down. That's why I bought the 3 that I did. So, yeah. So, videos also to look forward to. Just more jerseys. Just kind of wanted to show you guys my jersey collection. Maybe I'll rank. When I show you the whole collection, I'm not going to do a ranking. I'm just going to show you them all in alphabetical order and everything, team order. But say I might rank the top 100 or top 50 or top 50 just Adidas or top 50 Reeboks, top 50, I don't think I have 50 CCMs, never mind for that one. But yeah, I don't know, I'm sure we can have a little bit of fun. Like I said, I'm going to have a lot of time. The gyms are closed, so I don't know how fat I'm going to get. We stocked up on a decent amount of food, not a crazy amount of food. We didn't buy a whole shit ton of toilet paper, we don't need it. Just bought a reasonable amount of groceries to last hopefully 2 weeks. So I won't be leaving the house a whole lot. But hopefully you guys are all good. Let me know what you guys are up to for the next little while. Has your work been closed down? Are you work going to be closed down? Have you got sick? Let me know what's going on out there. I'm kind of curious to see what other people are going through at this point in time. But enough with that, we will move on to 3 jerseys to show you. So, 2 of these jerseys are coming from Cool Hockey. As you may all know, I don't want to brag or anything, but I'm pretty close friends with Neil from Post to Post. And he actually got himself a bit of a partnership with Cool Hockey, and I took full advantage of it because I don't want to say I was helping a friend out because I would have bought the jerseys regardless anyway, but if I kind of, you know, support him a little bit, it was definitely worth it. So I was able to get 2 jerseys using the post-to-post code. I got both of them for 30% off. I got one of them with a name and one of them with a blank. And I will show you the other one that I got for full price here in Calgary. I just found it actually at a local sports store and I decided to buy it. I'll go grab it. I'll show you. All right, this is the one that I got. The reason I got it is it's size 46 with the full size logo. And this is one of the top 5 jerseys when Adidas came out that I really wanted. I really wanted Carolina, Minnesota, this one obviously, And what are the other ones that I really wanted? I don't think it really much matters. But this is definitely one of the ones that I really wanted, and I'm super happy to have it. Nashville I really wanted, and New Jersey, and Columbus. Those were the ones that I really wanted when Adidas came out. This one, I absolutely love it. I have the white version of this with the full-size logo as well, so I had to get the matching one as well. I was trying to buy this one on Cool Hockey, but without the full-size logo guarantee, they can't guarantee you get the full-size logo, so I couldn't risk getting that. I actually bought a Carolina Hurricanes jersey probably about a month, maybe 2 months ago now. And I was talking with their little like chat window, what jerseys they thought I would have the best chance of getting a size 46 with a full-size logo. I gave them the ones that I was kind of looking for. They said Carolina should be a safe bet. No promises were given. Completely fine. So I took the chance. I bought it. Didn't work out. I actually did an unboxing. I never posted it. Maybe I'll post it here. All right. Let's find out. You guys can obviously see what team it is right now. That's not the concern. The concern is the logo. Am I keeping it? Fuck. Nope. It's the small logo. Man. Yeah, that logo just looks absolutely awful. The jersey is so freaking beautiful. And really disappointed. This will be going back, and I'll be trying my luck with a different team. Damn it, that kind of actually sucks. But yeah, it didn't have the full-size logo, and that is the... Between that one and Minnesota are the ones that I really, really, really freaking want from Adidas. But the small logo just will not fly for me. Same with the Avalanche one. So I did get this one as soon as I found it, and really, really happy with this, and I'll definitely be getting this one sent out in the next few months, hopefully, to get Pierre-Edward Belmar put on it, and super excited. So here's one jersey added into the collection. I'll show you the other two right now as well. I'm going to open this one first because I think this one will have a small logo on this one as well. And it is a blank, as long as I got the boxes right. I don't know why the boxes are two different sizes when they're both just one jersey. To be completely honest, I wouldn't be shocked if both of these were the smaller logo. But these are two that I can live with it being the smaller logo. They don't look horrible. One of them I really want, and the other one I also really want. So I got both of them. But let's see what we got here. Now, Cool Hockey has surprised me with the white Colorado and the white Tampa with the full-size logo, and I did not expect it at all. So, you never know, but this particular team, I doubt they will have sold a lot because they're not very good. So probably they haven't needed to restock and get the full-size logo. And I can already see the little button on it. The size 46, well actually all the Adidas don't have the button on them anymore. If you have, find the button on them and your size 46, it's going to be the small logo. Alright. See? Now, yeah, the small logo is really not ideal. But, truthfully, I'm probably not going to be wearing this jersey a heck of a lot. And in comparison to some of the logos, it doesn't look awful. But I absolutely love this Ottawa Senators jersey. I will get the home one as well. And, yeah, super excited. I will try them on. Damn, I took my net away. Now I don't have anywhere to hang these up. Let's do this. See if this works. I don't know if you guys can use it. Yeah, it's up there. Alright, second one. Now this one is the name, number. I got stitched on there, hand stitched and everything from Cool Hockey, so we'll see what they did. This one I wouldn't mind if it was the full size logo, because I have the white version of it in the smaller logo, and it doesn't look awful. Obviously, like I said, I'd prefer with the full-size logo, but I'm going to be shocked if it does. Yeah, so I can already tell it's going to have the smaller logo on it. But I don't care. My God. And I had to get Panarin. I absolutely love Panarin. He's one of my favorite players. Unreal. What a season he's been having. Well, had. I guess we don't really have much more hockey anymore. Really nicely stitched on and everything. I don't have a lot of issues or a lot of complaints with how Cool Hockey stitches everything on there. Quite nice. And my gosh, that is just beautiful. Yeah, like I said, with this one, with it being a word mark jersey the way it is, the smaller logo is kind of insignificant on these ones. I have the white one with the smaller logo as well. Can't really even call it a logo, but oh well. I'm still extremely happy, and this one is gonna look great in my collection. Goddamn! Like I said, I'll show you a little bit of the setup of the basement now, so let's do it.
Alright, so first things first, nice unfinished basement. Couple bobbleheads, Saskatoon blades, the Dallas Stars Phenom UC Jokinen, a little card carrier for the New York Rangers. Cards for random kind of European teams. Kimmo Timonen, Danny Briere, Gretzky, Bure, a Ginla bobblehead, an 8x10 of Thomas Tatar. Kevin Fiala, little New York Rangers thing I found at Winners, I think, of all places. Signed 8x10 from Jokinen in Vancouver, and signed one from Dallas. So his first stop and his last stop. France flag, very proud of that. Penguins puck, Dynamo puck, Mario. My goal puck that I scored like in 2011, I think. Cristobal Huey, a couple goalies. Got Mrazek, Jan Laxo from Boris Astana, Thibault. I think I have a Jokinen Captain Florida card. Paul Kariya, Peter Nedved. An 8x10 of Vadim Shapachov and Evgeny Dodonov. Shane Gostisbehere. A sweet gangster Penguins hat with a France soccer ball. And this is where the jerseys begin. That one will be a UC Jokinen Finland jersey. And this is the wall of Jokinen. For the most part. I have to get him put on that Vancouver Canucks jersey up there. And I need a home Detroit jersey with a full-size logo from Adidas so I can get a Jokinen Detroit jersey. Montreal, Regina Pats, Minnesota Wild, Winter Classic Buffalo, Oilers third, Toronto Arenas, and a 67-style Kings jersey from the Reebok when they kind of went back to that for a little bit for a couple games here and there. Sharks, that weird thing. HC Davos, potentially my favorite hockey team of all time. The jerseys that I will be doing the giveaway for, which I have not forgotten about, they will happen, just not sure quite when or how to work this out. Some hockey sticks. One rack of jerseys, the other Kings jersey. Dirty laundry, which you don't care about. I've got a bunch of these new 8x10s that I've got going, and I'm super excited about. Backstrom, Horvat, Scheifele, Domi, Mario, Aho, Svechnikov, Spengler Cup. I love that roof. Oh my god. Novosibirsk, Elias Lindholm, Ovi, Kucherov. Look at that sweet stud, Kopitar. The guy who checks himself into boards, Florian Hardy. And, oh dear, a little heavy there. Oh dear, what have I done? And Marner. That's pretty much about it. All right, dirty laundry. Oh boy. I can hang up some jerseys over here. I usually have one up there as well. I still have one net on this side. Just a little mini net. Obviously, you guys probably just saw all those hanging up. I obviously will be switching these out for each different video. I have more cards up here. Here is my defenseman one. Some of my favorite D-men. Some of my favorite goalies. And some of my favorite forwards. An old Florida Panthers jersey that I got duped on because it said it was a men's medium. It was not a men's medium. A Moscow jersey, the CSKA. Some helmets, all that equipment down there. I need to try to sell my actual hockey bag. Just some tape, and I think there's a couple like pairs of like pant covers in there. Mini fridge, nicely stocked. Sorry, Neil, I completely stole your idea for the stickers on the fridge. I had a bunch of these and I figured I didn't really have any place to put them. I never would have thought of that. Obviously just some more jerseys that you guys don't really see. Got some jerseys hanging up there because why not? A bag of gloves. Pretty much just all gloves. Camera, so this is what I'm looking at when I'm talking to you fine folks. I need to put a couple more jerseys up, maybe at least one, maybe two up in that corner. And obviously I take down the lights and the camera so I can have access to shooting on my net with the fancy tiles from Hockey Shot. And there's the second rack of jerseys. And that's pretty much it, guys. So I'll switch back to that camera right there and we'll finish up this video. All right, so that pretty much wraps up this video, guys. Hopefully you kind of enjoyed that a little bit, kind of the behind the scenes tour. I know I've done them in the past before, but I figured it'd be worth kind of doing a little bit of an update because I have to switch things around a little bit. The reason I put the net over there was just simply because of the fact that that black background that you guys see can see behind there are some of the jerseys. Every time I miss the net or if it hit the post and bounced behind it, it was just tearing the black part. So I completely replaced the black part with all new. It's just like a tablecloth that I got at the dollar store, but there's like six of them up there. So that was a bitch to do, so I don't really want to have to deal with that again. I took down a table that I had, and I was kind of able to have a little bit more room, so the net over there just makes a little bit more sense. It's kind of unfortunate because now I have to hang the jerseys up there, which I don't really like. But, oh well. Like I said, I did not forget about the jersey giveaway. We will be doing that. It probably will not be happening for a little while now, especially with the whole world ending, seemingly. So we'll see how that goes. And like I said, hopefully I can do some more jersey videos here for you because I'm going to have a lot of time on my hands and I just don't really want to get fat. So I'm going to get so fat, guys. All my hard work last summer in the gym, gone. It is going to be gone within 3 days of not having a job, pretty much. The gym's closed. And I know I'm not motivated enough to work out at home. But we will see you guys again soon in the next video, and hopefully you guys are all being safe out there, and yeah, don't have a whole lot else. If you guys want, you can check me on Instagram as well. Also, Twitter. I usually don't like leaving that one. I usually don't recommend people follow me on that one. Although I have been a little bit more active on there recently, so
maybe it's worth checking out. If not, I don't really care. If you guys want to subscribe and see more videos, I would also really appreciate that. But if not, I understand. Kind of boring at times, so, and I don't upload a whole lot. Completely up to you, but whatever you end up doing, hopefully you have a good day. And I will see you guys again soon, if I haven't, I already did say that. But, yeah, take care. Bye.